Hello, everyone. Welcome to my very first video of 2022. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you my top 10 purchases that I made from Amazon. Like many of you, in the last couple of years, I have really upped my online shopping, from clothing to makeup to household goods. I don't leave my house nearly as much as I used to, and the convenience of buy online, pick up in store from a lot of retailers and just the quick shipping that a lot of stores are offering these days has just really made it so easy to shop from home, from my phone or my computer. It's almost too easy. I buy a lot of stuff that I probably shouldn't have purchased in the first place because I really didn't need it. I've been influenced by influencers. So today I wanted to narrow it down to 10 items that if I lost them, I would immediately repurchase them. And in one instance, I've already made a repurchase. So why don't I start off with the jewelry that I'm wearing today? These earrings I have purchased in 3 colors. I have the white, obviously, and then I purchased the beige, and then I have the blue somewhere, but I seem to have misplaced them. These earrings were $10, and I absolutely love them. I realize they're not going to be everyone's taste, but if you like a feminine, comfortable earring that is going to stand out, even if you have long hair, I definitely recommend these. I like that the design of these earrings makes it so they're very secure on your ears, but they don't pinch, and they come in so many colors, and you just cannot beat the price. Some of you might be thinking, Risa, how good is the quality for that price? I've had these for probably 5 or 6 months, if not longer. At least I've had the white ones for that long, and I think they still look great, from the enamel, it hasn't chipped, to the rhinestones, none have fallen out, and they haven't loosened at all either. I just think they're a really, really great buy. Next is this necklace. It's actually 2 separate pieces, and both necklaces are adjustable. I like to wear the one that has the pendant with my initial on it a little bit lower than just this chain link necklace. I have had no problems with my neck turning green or having any itchiness from it not being real gold. When I was younger, I used to have a severe allergy to anything that wasn't 14 karat gold, 24 karat gold. I just could not wear it. My skin would itch, or if they were earrings, my ears would itch. I don't know what happened. I don't seem to have that problem anymore. And I just love this necklace. I've seen similar necklaces go for 2, 3, even 4 times the price on other websites. So if you like this look, of course, this and everything I mentioned in today's video will be linked down below in the description box. And by the way, this necklace has 18,659 reviews and 4.5 out of 5 stars. All right, next up are my lashes. People are always asking me in the comment section of my videos either what lashes I'm wearing or what lashes do I recommend for someone who is new to wearing false lashes, or for someone who has hooded eyes like I do, downturned eyes, what's the best style, what's the best shape. I am so happy to have discovered these from a brand called Mosvani. These are the natural flares. They are faux mink, and I'm pretty sure I paid under $10 for the set of 3. I actually just reordered these because I don't want to be without them, and you know how Amazon can be sometimes. One day something's in stock, the next day it's not, and then it comes back in stock, and the price sometimes changes. Anyway, I ordered another set because I just love these lashes. Here's a closer look at how I have trimmed them. I like to trim my lashes different lengths. Sometimes I like to use them just as corner lashes. Sometimes I want them to be 3/4 lashes, and sometimes I want them to be full strips. So that's why you see that I have them cut at different lengths. Today I am wearing just the small chunk. I cut off the ends, and then I wear the inner portion of the lash on the outer portion of my eyes. And they're just so wispy and natural looking. They have a clear band. And I think that's really important, especially for a newbie when it comes to false lashes. When lashes have a very thick and stiff band, they are much more difficult to work with. You are going to become much more frustrated with the application. And with a clear band, they're just so much easier to use. And you can go over the top with a liquid liner. And these days you can actually find liquid liner that's lash glue. And I'm not talking about the magnetic lashes and lash glue. I'm not personally a fan of those, but you can purchase liquid liner that is just lash glue. So that makes it super simple to apply these lashes and then also have them look natural. So you don't have to go over the band with any type of liquid liner. All right, now I want to talk about my favorite fashion find from the past year. I purchased this dress right here in two different colors. I believe I first saw this dress on TikTok. Some fashion content creator was wearing it. Unfortunately, I can't remember exactly who it was to give them credit for me finding this dress and sharing it now with you. But it just looked so pretty and flattering on her. And to be honest with you, I do find purchasing fashion or even jewelry on Amazon can be very hit or miss. Sometimes the quality can be amazing and sometimes it can be just not so good and you feel like, well, I got what I paid for. In this case, I definitely feel like I got more quality than what I actually paid for this dress. The medium fit my size 6 body perfectly. I wore this dress to an event. It was the opening of a jewelry store in one of the newer resorts here in Las Vegas, and I received so many compliments. When I told people that it was from Amazon, the response I got was, "Oh my God, you're kidding. I am going to order that." And of course, that always makes you feel good when someone compliments your outfit and they think it's a lot more expensive than it actually was. I just think this dress is so elegant and it's great because you can wear a regular bra with it. You can wear Spanx with it if you choose to. It's a good length. I am 5'7". If you are not quite that tall, you may want to get it hemmed or use some sort of fashion tape to make it a little bit more to the length that is most flattering on you. But overall, I absolutely adore this dress and highly recommend it. All right, before I get to my must-have travel items from Amazon, I want to talk about this lamp right here behind me. For the longest time, I had this lamp in the background of my videos, and I would have people asking me on every single video, without fail, where that lamp was from, how they could get one. There was maybe one or two people over the time that I had that lamp in the background, which I'll still put back up once in a while. There'll always be one or two people that will say, "You need to get rid of that lamp, it's hideous." I disagree. I think it's really pretty, and I think based on the comments that I've received over the years, most people thought it was very pretty. So I always felt bad having to tell people that it was from Home Goods, and I got it a couple of years ago, and I searched the internet for hours trying to find this exact lamp, or at least something very similar. I didn't really have any luck. Unfortunately, the lamp had no name brand even on it anywhere. To make a long story short, I decided I was going to try and find a lamp, a beautiful lamp that would look pretty in my background, but that people could actually purchase if they liked it. Of course, shortly after I purchased this lamp and I had been linking it, it sold out. When I went to go make the links for this video, lo and behold, Amazon shows that it is sold out in the gold. The silver one is still in stock, and then I also have linked one that's very, very similar. To me, this lamp looks way more expensive than it is. It did take me about 15, 20 minutes or so to hang every single one of the crystal strands, but it was well worth it. Very easy to follow instructions. I think this lamp would look beautiful on bedroom end tables, or on your vanity, or in any space that you want to add a little sparkle to. Up next are three of my must-haves for travel. I couldn't quite remember if I had spoken about these travel brush holders in another video or not, but even if I did, they are worth talking about again. I know based on my order history that I purchased two more this year. These brush holders are a must-have if you travel. You don't even need to use them to hold brushes. You can use them to hold eye pencils, mascaras, lip liners, anything really. I like that they have the little elasticized bands in there so you can have things be really secure. What I'll do is I'll take my bigger brushes, like my blush and powder brushes and contour brushes, and put those in the center, and then I'll take my smaller eye brushes and put them around the perimeter in those little elastic spaces so they're away from the other brushes and they're easier to find. When I travel, I take sort of an insane amount of makeup and brushes and tools, so that's why I have two of them. Most people probably only need one because they do hold quite a bit. And another thing I really like about these is how they fold down and they stand up perfectly on any table, and you can see everything very, very clearly. When I do my makeup in a hotel room or whenever I'm out of town staying at someone's house, I always have them just sort of folded over next to my mirror for easy accessibility, and you can't beat the price of these either. Moving on to this toiletry bag. This is a bag that I take with me when I am going on a road trip or I am having a staycation here in Las Vegas at one of the hotel resorts. This is not good for me for when I travel by air, because of course when you travel by air, all of your liquids have to be 3 ounces or less, and this is not the kind of bag that I would want to check in. So for me, it would only work if I didn't have any liquids in it, and I like to put my shampoo and conditioner in this bag, again, when I am going on a road trip or having a staycation, my hairspray, my body glow. I like the zippered compartments that this has. In one compartment, I'll put in like my lash glue, my nail clippers, my little scissors that I use for trimming lashes. There's just so much space in this bag, and it comes in so many different colors. You can hang it on the back of the door in the bathroom. I think it's a must-have. So I've talked about travel brush holders. I've talked about the travel toiletry bag. And then now I want to talk about this backpack. This is a newer purchase of mine. I had to include it in this video because I was so, so happy with it. I used it for my trip to Mexico over Christmas, and it worked beautifully. I needed to take my laptop. I needed to take, obviously, my passports. I am someone who cannot use a trackpad. This is embarrassing to say, but I really cannot use the trackpad on the MacBook. I never learned how to use it, so I always take my mouse and my mouse pad. I know, that's why I said it's embarrassing. I really should learn how to use the trackpad, but for now I do pack my mouse and the mouse pad and my charger, and there was just room for everything in this bag. This bag has great reviews, which is why I purchased it. It does have a built-in charging port. I did not use that, but that was definitely a selling point, as was the fact that it came in so many colors. I was just really blown away by how many compartments are in this bag. And I used the, not the very front zipper compartment, but the one behind that with the pockets for mine and my husband's passports. And then there was a spot for my eyeglasses case. Basically, if you are in the market for a really good backpack for travel, then I highly, highly recommend this one. I love mine. All right, I've just got two more products left to talk about. This one right here is more practical than it is attractive. That's what I'll say about it. This is a wall mount for all of my Dyson tools. I have the hairdryer, I have the Airwrap, and it was a little bit difficult to figure out a place to put everything where I could see it all. And I happened to just be browsing on Amazon one day and it came up, or maybe it came up in an ad somewhere, I don't recall, but I saw it and I immediately thought, I'm gonna try that. That looks like a great way to store and organize my Dyson tools. I cannot say that I mounted it to the wall myself. My father did it for me, but it took him maybe 10 minutes or less to install it, to mount it on the wall. And as I said moments ago, I think it's very practical and I like having it. I love having it, in fact. I just don't know if I love the way it looks in my bathroom, but it's utilitarian. It's not like it's supposed to be some beautiful sort of thing. And until they come out with something, I don't know, prettier, I'm going to continue to be happy that I have the one that I do. And I have saved my favorite item, and unfortunately the most expensive item, for last. This is my GE Opal Ice Maker, countertop ice maker. So this is the bar area in my home. And I knew when I remodeled this area last year that I wanted to have some sort of ice maker built in. Well, I thought I wanted to have an ice maker built in. But then my friend recommended this to me because this is something we can actually take with us when we eventually move to another home. And who knows, someone who buys the house from us might not want to have this bar area at all, might want to take it out completely. Basically, I was just convinced that this was the better way to go. I like to make cocktails. I like to have friends over. When I have family come to town, we like to sit around outside by our fire pit and have a drink, and having the ice maker right there is great. That way I don't have to walk back and forth to the kitchen where our refrigerator is, and it constantly makes new ice. Can't recall off the top of my head the specifics of how much ice this makes per hour. All of that information can be found online. I personally really like the nugget ice that this forms. And it is a little bit loud. That was something that I did not expect. When it is making the ice, it does make some interesting noises, but only when it's, you know, making more ice. It's not all the time. And then there is an app that you can download on your phone to have it make more ice or less ice, or just turn it off completely to have it stop making ice. There is a reason this GE Opal ice maker has such incredible reviews, and that's because it's super easy to use, it's convenient, the ice tastes good. What more could you want? All right, everyone, that'll do it for my top 10 Amazon purchases of 2021. If you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, I would love it if you would consider doing so. All you have to do is hit that subscribe button and you will become part of the Risa Does Makeup family. You can also find more content from me on TikTok and on Instagram. The username is the same everywhere. It's all Risa Does Makeup. Thank you so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you in my next video.